about a friend that I had that that really changed my life, and I never got a chance to tell them how much they changed my life. So this is called Clockwork. My grandmother owned a Kelly green clock with a blue face and three crimson hands. And when the room is quiet, you can hear the soft countdown. Tick, tick, tick. It reminded her that time was limited. And I remember that Christmas. She stood out like a sore thumb. Her bright magenta robe lit up the somber, faded seafoam nursing home. And I remember she said to me, "I'll see you again soon, sweetheart." When your name comes up in conversation, the first thing I see are a pair of chartreuse green eyes and a clockwork of thoughts bustling behind them. A machine of ideas, manufacturing emotions at such a rapid rate, the filter can hardly keep up. But what drew me to you was not your quick wit or your short fuse. It was your blatant honesty. Shortly after we became friends, I remember you were standing in the corner of the room, drowning in a sea of overlapping voices. It was pure chaos, and your face turned crimson, and you turned to me and roared, "Shut up! Shut up, everyone! Shut up!" And I knew the definition of bravery before you. I had just never seen it. When you told me about the screaming and about the fighting, and about the drinking, your voice was a deep navy blue, and I had felt sadness before you, but it was nothing like this. You unlocked the deepest, darkest corners of your mind and beckoned me to unearth a capsule buried so deeply beneath the surface. And somewhere along this odyssey, I became transfixed, captivated, dumbfounded, inspired, awestruck, perplexed, fascinated by this picture that you painted of a life so honestly human, and you asked me why you, of all people, deserved kindness, deserved love, because you saw yourself as this broken, messy thing, but my God, it was you that taught me that messy doesn't have to be bad. Messy is authentic. Messy is real. Messy is beautiful. And you told me that we would be friends until we were old and gray, and that you'd be in the crowd at every one of my concerts, and that we'd storm Sin City at 21. And you promised me you would always pick up the phone. No matter what. But what you forgot to tell me was that time is limited and that clocks continue to tick and the world continues to spin and life continues to move forward and children grow up and grown-ups drown their feelings in liquor, in drugs, in meaningless sex, but can we stop the clock for just a moment? Can we backtrack? Rewind. Can we go back to 13 years old? Because when you're 13 years old, you don't want their body. You just want their ears to listen. And you so desperately ached for someone to listen, someone to heal your wounds, someone to stitch your frayed heart. But my dear, I was not a physician. I was no seamstress, no saint, no magician. I was a girl. I was just a girl. My grandmother's Kelly green clock stopped ticking. Her heart stopped beating. And you stopped picking up. But my honest love